Arise, Jerusalem, and look to the east, and see your children gathered from the rising to the setting of the sun. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today we celebrate the solemnity of the Epiphany, the great arrival of the Magi to see Jesus bringing their gold, frankincense, and myrrh. My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. May the splendor of your majesty, O Lord, we pray, shed its light upon our hearts, that we may pass through the shadows of this world and reach the brightness of our eternal home. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow. For the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you. Dromedaries from Midian and Ephah, all from Sheba shall come, bearing gold and frankincense, and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
Lord, every nation on earth.
O God, with your judgment endow the king, and with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice, and your afflicted ones with judgment.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
Justice shall flower in his days, and profound peace till the moon be no more. May he rule from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
The kings of Tarshish and the isles shall offer gifts. The kings of Arabia and Seba shall bring tribute. All kings shall pay him homage. All nations shall serve him.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
For he shall rescue the poor when he cries out, and the afflicted when he has no one to help him. He shall have pity for the lowly and the poor. The lives of the poor he shall save.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Big star. It's always one of the joys of celebrating Mass here. If you're at home and you have no idea what I'm talking about, I'll show you.
It's about the size of a football field. All right. I'm just kidding, of course.
But it's neat, isn't it? The beautiful star that we have here shining over. And if you hadn't known recently, the alignment of it, is it Saturn and Jupiter that were aligned up together? Was it those two? I forget. There's a couple of the planets that were lined up recently. And you could stand outside right around the 21st of December and look up, and it was a gigantic star. It's like once every 800 years that the planets line up that closely that it creates this giant star. And it gives us this sense of the wonder of what was going on with the arrival of the Magi, these strange three persons who arrive, three or however many there were of them, that arrive to give honor to this newborn king of the Jews. For us, they can represent something of the spiritual life to us. They can give us a way of looking at our spiritual lives and asking ourselves, is this where I'm at in my spiritual life? Or which part of their journey might I be at this particular moment? So you can catch these little glimpses of moments. So we know that they are Magi, this a group of people that lived to the east of the Holy Land, and part of their culture, well, you know how it is for us, when we get around a campfire, we have to pull out chocolate and graham crackers and marshmallows, right? That's one of our things that we just have to do when we get around a fire together. Well, for them, sitting at night, one of the things that their culture did was to spend time looking at the stars and trying to figure out, is God speaking to us through the stars? Imagine spending that kind of time and that kind of energy. God, what is your will for us? How do you want us to live our lives and to... that the Lord would be speaking to them through the stars. In this particular case, he is, isn't he? They are discerning, well, God, what do you want us to do with our life? And the Lord is speaking to them through astrology, through astronomy. It's kind of a science for them and a spiritual way of life. And so are we searching? Is there a part in our own spiritual lives where we are asking God deep questions? Lord, what do I do about this? What do I do about my job? What do I do about this illness that has entered in our family? What do we do about our finances this year? The big questions of life, and to bring them before the Lord, to be asking them of God, not just trying to figure it out on our own, but that we are people in our spiritual lives who turn to the Lord and bring our concerns and our worries to Him. Are we doing that? Are we a people who discern what God is asking of us? Another thing that you see the Magi do then is they get some clarity, and that does happen for us. We get these moments of clarity. This is what the Lord wants me to do. And so they act on it. They begin this journey. And acting, sometimes that's the part that we get stuck in, isn't it? We figured out what the Lord wants us to do, but we get afraid of the difficulty of the journey that's ahead. Now, for most of us, when we say, hey, let's take a journey to the Twin Cities, it's okay. Okay, so you pack the car. It's going to be a three-hour trip. Do you have the car seat for the kids? Do you have enough snacks along? And do we have the DVD player to put on the back seat of the car with the kids? You know, how many gas stations do we want to stop at on the way there? It's not that hard.
I mean, it's just time in the car for most of us. But back in the day, for them to travel the kind of distance that they did, that would have taken days, weeks, for them to travel from one location to the next, that was not easy. It's by camel, or by horseback, or by mule, or by walking, a distance that probably, you know, let's imagine it was the same from here to Chicago, of a distance. That's not an easy trip to make if you're gonna walk it, or ride it by horseback. How are we gonna get there? How do we, you know, where are we gonna stop for our food, for our resources? And so getting the courage to actually do what we're supposed to do in the spiritual life, that can be difficult sometimes when we start measuring out, oh, I gotta go talk to this person, or I gotta go do this task, or I gotta face my financial issues here that I don't wanna do. I mean, I know for myself, I just break out in sweats when I gotta do my taxes, when I gotta get paperwork lined up and find all of my receipts and all of that stuff and kind of get my life in order. It's just hard. I don't like doing it. But there's something too in the spiritual life when we know this is what the Lord wants me to do, getting the courage to do it. So I've asked the Lord, Lord, what do you want me to do? Now he's told me, now Lord, give me the courage and let me act. May I step out with courage into that space that I don't want to go into. Even though there's going to be trials and tribulations. The third thing is that they come upon obstacles. They thought as they were arriving that this was going to be easy, but now they run into Herod. Herod is, he's not a nice king. He's not nice. He's very cruel. This is the same Herod who becomes very envious that he finds out another king is going to be born in the same territory as he is. And out of jealousy and envy, he sends out his soldiers into the town area of Bethlehem to kill every child within 2 years of age. I don't want somebody to replace me. And so his action here of getting the three magi, getting the magi to go and find where Jesus is and then come back and tell him, is not out of love and reverence, even though he says so. It's out of spite and anger and envy. And so this opposition that they're coming up against, the opposition of travel and the opposition of we're kind of in a foreign territory. We thought we were doing something good here by talking about the Lord's will, but it turns out it's becoming sort of a death threat, a challenge to us. That's what it can be like sometimes, isn't it, in the spiritual life? We think that we're doing the Lord's will, we're going about the difficulty of facing the opposition, and we come up against serious roadblocks. I thought, as spouses, we were on the same team about this. We're not. We have significant differences about how to go about taking care of our kids or dealing with our whatever the problem, the financial issue, whatever it is. We're in a different place. And the challenge of that then becomes of, Lord, how are we going to get through this when we face opposition? I think we all, in the spiritual life, we all want it to be nice and smooth. No. Most of the time, we have to enter into the spiritual life knowing that most all of the time, it's going to be with opposition along with it. You want to have a prayer life? It's not going to be easy. You want to be devotional and doing certain things as a family, making sure we're all around the table to have our sacred meal together. It's probably not going to happen very easily. Oh, but we got this we want to do. We want this. Can't we leave the TV on? Can't we do this? Can't we do... It's hard. Making sacrifices in the midst of the journey itself is a hard thing to do. So we're following the Lord's will, trying to discern. We are making an act of faith and we're stepping out and out of our comfort zone. We're facing opposition. And now we see the Magi as they arrive. They bring gifts for this new Messiah that they are encountering, for the King. Do I bring the best of myself for God? I mean, these gifts that they bring, gold, frankincense, and myrrh, those are gifts that you would give to a king. I don't know about you, but I don't get king Christmas presents and birthday gifts. My brother should know that that's what he kind of gifts he should be giving me, but he doesn't give me those gifts. I'm just teasing. But to get, you know, a big crate of gold that they bring, and they give this as a gift over to Jesus as a king. Frankincense, I mean, that kind of stuff is used in the temple for really big worship. And so it's hard to come by, it's expensive, and it's stuff used in worship of God. And for them to bring that gift and to leave it as a gift so that Joseph and Mary, they know that they have God in their midst. You saw what I did at the beginning of Mass for the altar, the preparation of the altar here. And because we're going to have Jesus here soon, we incense around the altar as the sign of reverence and respect, our prayers rising up before the Lord. If you had baby Jesus in your house, what would you do to make your house ready and worthy for the Lord? It's better than any traveler or guest that could arrive. And so frankincense as a gift is this incredible gift that they're giving to him. And myrrh, a preparation for his death one day. Imagining now that Mary will hold on to this myrrh, whether it's in liquid form or crystallized form that's kind of hardened over time, that they would then melt down with heat and then be able to use that anointing the body of Jesus. You know how every once in a while when I'm doing baptisms there, I'll pull out the oil and I'll say it smells like the Holy Spirit, right? Make the kids smell it. Take a nice big smell. It smells like the Holy Spirit. That's because there's myrrh in it. It smells really good. It's really, really good. That's just, they use it for confirmation, baptism, confirmation, and we use it for holy orders. They anoint the hands of the priest when they do holy orders. So, these really great gifts. Do I give my best to God? With my life, in my spiritual life, does he get the best version out of me? Am I preparing myself for the worship that I do when I go to Mass on the weekends? Is it the treasured hour of my week? Or just something that I gotta get through? Is it the treasured time that I have? So it's important to me not just showing up at the last minute if I can help it, but being there enough of a time early that my soul calms down. And I'm able to enter into the readings and allow the readings to mean something to me. I'm able to go through the Mass. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. It's an intentional movement of my heart. The glory to God in the highest is the best gloria that I can offer. If I, you know, I have to compare it to other things in myself. Do I get more excited about other things like football, baseball, basketball? Do I get more excited about those things than I do the things about God? Well, then I need to improve on that. That I'm giving the best of myself to the Lord. Praying in my life, having a relationship with God in my life, making sure that the things, you know, is it good and holy things in, good and holy things out, or is it garbage in, garbage out? So how am I spending my time and my energy throughout the day, and how am I treating other persons? Loving the Lord my God with all of my heart, all of my soul, all of my strength, everything of my person, loving my neighbor as I love myself. All of those things we've been reviewing over the last number of weeks. Bringing the best gift for Jesus of myself. And then you notice that they don't go back the same way. The Magi return back by another way. And this is how it is with Jesus. When we've encountered Jesus, it should change us such that we live a different way from that point forward. And so we surrender that over to the Lord. Lord, I desire to be changed by you. I know this is not a short encounter thing. This is a long encounter with you. And so it's the visits over time that change us with Jesus. It's that ongoing relationship time after time. I think of my relationship with my grandparents. And it wasn't just going to visit them one time when I was a kid. It was all the visits over and over and over again that built those relationships with my grandparents. built and fostered this kind of love and affection for them, wanting to spend time with them, appreciating them, understanding about the dynamics of life, you know, that from they used to be young like my parents, they used to be kids like me, now they've gotten to that seasoned place of life. Seasoned. Just beautiful, rich, golden years of life in which they're able to look upon the legacy that they've been leaving behind of life and to share in that with their own children and their grandchildren. There's something about that relationship of growing with Jesus over time, allowing myself to be changed by him as I go through the wiles of life and the difficulties. So I'm discerning, I'm acting, facing opposition, offering the best of my gifts, and allowing myself to be changed so I can move about in a different way of life. I can see then how the Magi are so important for our spiritual lives as images of what we are to be.
For the church born of Mary at the cross, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the catechumens and candidates for confirmation and Eucharist, marriage, ordination, and religious consecration, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For local and national leaders and public servants, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, as we celebrate this Christmas season, that the eyes of our hearts may be enlightened, and we may know what is the hope that belongs to our call in Christ Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the sick, the poor, the persecuted and abandoned ones, that they may be consoled by our Mother's powerful protection, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faithful departed ones, that God may bless them in Christ with every spiritual blessing in his heavenly home, giving them eternal rest and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold in our hearts, for the prayers written in our book of intercessions, and for Lee Geiser, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord our God, we are grateful that your Son Jesus has entered into our world. May we, on our spiritual journeys, be like the Magi and come to understand who Christ is for us and to follow him all the way to heaven. We ask all of these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just some things you might not know. You know, with the incensing, as the priest is doing that, the style that I do there is from the old rite, the old Latin rite, doing it three times with the sign of the cross and the three circles. And then as I'm going around at certain times of the year, like with the Easter candle at a funeral or at baptism or something like that, it's one of the times of the year that you'll see the priest stop and incense the Easter candle. Another thing that the priest is able to do is incense the Christmas nativity creche. And then pretty much every time I do it, you also see me incensing the crucifix that's for us. If there weren't one behind me, I would have been incensing the one that's here on the altar for myself. But that's when you see the priest stopping to do those moments of incense, that's what he's doing. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, our offerings in honor of the appearing of your only begotten Son and the first fruits of the nations, that to you praise may be rendered and eternal salvation be ours, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Donald, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which your only begotten Son, eternal with you in your glory, appeared in a human body, truly sharing our flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father,
Giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The brightness of God illumined the holy city Jerusalem, and the nations will walk by its light. Thank you.
Let us pray. Renewed by sacred nourishment, we implore your mercy, O Lord, that the star of your justice may shine always bright in our minds, and that our true treasure may ever consist in our confession of you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a few announcements here. I have a chalk that if you wish to do the Epiphany blessing of your home, that's where you take and you put the little numbers and the letters on the door above that. I was not smart enough, sorry about that, to get a printout of how to do the blessing, but you can find this online really easy. So if you have any of your family members that can search up Epiphany blessing, it'll pop right up, okay? And then you can just download the little blessing thing. So you just need a piece of chalk. It either can be blessed chalk, or you can bless it yourself with the blessing that comes as part of the prayer that you do there as a family. Family can do that blessing, and that's fine. But I'll bless a bunch of chalk now and have it here by the baptismal font if you wish to take a piece home with you to bless your home, okay? And you're writing 20CMB21. 2021 with CMB in the middle, which stands for Caspar, Melchior, and Balthazar, okay? Or Christus Mansionem Benedicat. May Christ bless this house. Okay, that's what that's for. So we'll have that blessing of the chalk here. Why don't I just bless that right now? Let us pray. Loving God, bless this chalk which you have created, that it may be helpful to your people, and grant that through the invocation of your most holy name, that we who use it in faith to write upon the door of our home the names of your holy ones, Caspar, Melchior, and Balthazar, may receive health of body and protection of soul for all who dwell in or visit our home. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Good. And then you just put that on the door frames, the windows, whatever you want to do of your house. But it's typically the main entrances that you bless with that. And I just write it right on the door frame around on the top of the door frame. Okay, but on the door if the frame doesn't allow it. There we go. Would you put those there so I don't forget? Just right on the ledge. Next week, or January 9th, so Saturday, January 9th, right after the Mass is done, we'll be taking down the Christmas decorations and all that. Christmas for us goes all the way up till the baptism of the Lord next weekend, so please keep your Christmas stuff up at home if you can as a sign of rebellion against the culture, okay? This is a good one. You can rebel by keeping up your Christmas ornaments. So we'll be doing that next Saturday after Mass if you can stick around and help out with taking things down. And then tomorrow I'm going to be doing privately the Epiphany water blessing and blessing of salt like I did last year and the year before that. This is my last year to do it that I have permission from the bishop. So I'm going to make a whole bunch of holy water and a whole bunch of blessed salt. If you'd like some, it'll be available at the daily masses and next weekend at the weekend masses for you to pick up. Okay, I'll have big, gigantic jugs full of water. So you can bring a container from home if you want, and I'll have some water bottles available. You can take that home. It's the high octane holy water. Okay, it's a 45-minute blessing, all in Latin. Woo! It's great. Outside the parking area out here, if you do happen to know, it's actually handicap parking, in case you did not know that. And as you're parking out there, whoever's parking, all our handicapped folks and anybody else who might be parking out there, just make sure you're spaced far enough that people can open up ramps and stuff out of their vehicles. Sometimes they get parked a little too tight together and it gets a little difficult for our folks who are wheeling in, right? So make sure you guys have nice, safe entry and exit into the building. Here we go. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, who has called you out of darkness into his wonderful light, pour out in kindness his blessing upon you and make your hearts firm in faith, hope, and charity.
Amen.
And since in all confidence you follow Christ, who today appeared in the world as a light shining in darkness, may God make you too a light for your brothers and sisters.
Amen.
And so when your pilgrimage is ended, may you come to him whom the Magi sought as they followed the star, and whom they found with great joy, the light from light, who is Christ the Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.